Brilliant.
Yeah. Okay. So hopefully you got a few. Hopefully you got a few tips there, because I think. Yeah. So, planning resources for a lesson in primary school. So, we talked about that before. You need to keep the kids active. It's very important to keep kids active, because if you don't keep them active, they're not going to engage in the lesson. Okay. So, when planning a lesson, you need to make sure not pull for entertaining. You've got to keep the children involved. Okay. So they're usually three structured sections. So when we did our lesson plan, we based our lesson around three different areas. So we had a starter, we had a main activity, and we had a primary activity. And we had to make sure it was all fitted into an hour. Yeah. So this is mine and Josh's example. So at the start, we did like a little vocab drill. So like, do you remember when you were in year seven? You would like chanting numbers and stuff like that. So it's sort of like that. So we chanted the French and they chanted the English and things like that. And then the main activity, what we did was decided to do like a daily routine. So they would learn the words in a group. Like each person will have a different phrase to learn. And then at the end, they were all coming together and then create a role play for themselves. And the last thing they did was bingo. So almost testing, memorising how many words to learn. So teaching a lesson. In the first lesson, you're always going to be nervous. No doubt about it. Every single one of you will be nervous, because Ravi, you were probably nervous as well, weren't you, even though you're a good speaker. Top tips. So use a balance of both the target language. Now, me and Josh found that out because, some schools may know more than others. So one of the schools, one of the schools I remember, we tried to ask them to, écouter et répéter, so try to listen to repeat. But they didn't know, did they?
No.
But at another school, they did. So it kind of depends. So you've got to use a balance, and you've got to be, you've got to adapt to the situation, and ensure that your pronunciation is clear as well. So I remember Miss saying, because we went to St John's Fisher, our second primary school, and we reckon that school was, quite intelligent kids. So you've got to make sure, pronunciation is clear as well, whatever language you're doing. Some children may get involved more than others. So when you're doing interactive activities, they may put their hands up more. But when it's like main activities and group discussions, try to get them involved. Yeah, Josh?
Yeah, can I just go off what you said there? When you're trying to get class to answer questions, like do a bit of a mix. So pick the people with the hands up, obviously, and then trying to get others involved. So maybe people with the hands down, maybe pick on them.
Yeah.
And then that gets everybody involved.
Yeah. So you've just got to be prepared for anyone in the class. So you've got to make sure to really adapt. Yeah. Try and get pupils engaged. So doing the vocab drill, doing the flashcards, etc. Is very important. So after teaching a lesson, so again, briefly mentioned that, so after you've done your first lesson, you've got to evaluate your positives and your negatives.
Yeah.
So if you just work as teams now, and see what you want to do, fill them out, and
what?
You've got how many minutes, miss? 15 minutes?
No, why not?